On the Isle of Wight, a unique passenger hovercraft faces the toughest weekend of the year. Thousands of tourists are visiting the island for a sailing regatta. And today, thousands more are coming to see the famous fireworks at the end of the races. Hovercraft pilot Jock Darrock has made 30 successful trips back and forth, dodging and weaving through the regatta traffic. The hovercraft has been running for hours. Now it needs to fill up.
Engineers, it's all on fire.
Yeah, go ahead, sir.
So I'm going to need to refuel.
Yeah, no problem, mate.
Lovely, thank you.
Engineer Tom must quickly push over 1,000 litres of diesel into the hovercraft, which should last another 260 miles.
So just like a racing pit stop, we've got 5 minutes to deliver the fuel into the craft.
About 3 minutes behind schedule.
As the fuel pumps spin, ground crew manager Lee boards the passengers.
We are relying on the engineers to be quick, like the ground staff and the crew. They are a well-oiled machine.
While Jock monitors the fuel intake from the cockpit.
We've got 5 minutes now, just starting to load the passengers. Fuel's coming in nicely.
It can be a bit touch and go.
Lee finally gets the passengers safely in their seats.
OK, that's it. She's full up, we're ready to go.
The fuel stop has delayed the departure. To get the service back on schedule, Jock must squeeze every last bit of speed out of his machine. Every part of this hovercraft is designed for lightning-fast acceleration. A light but strong precision-engineered aluminium skeleton. And a cockpit made from featherweight glass fiber create a sleek cabin that sits low down to improve aerodynamics and save fuel. And a hydraulic piston at the hub of each propeller twists the blades. So just like a helicopter pilot, Jock can angle his rotors for maximum thrust to give the hovercraft a boost when he really needs it. The lightweight design and adjustable propellers give Jock and his revolutionary craft the speed to claw back lost time.
We're still running. We're running at maximum RPM.
The hovercraft's 850 RPM propellers get the vessel in on schedule. But now, Jock is anxious to get the passengers boarded even more quickly than usual. On his radar, he's spotted an enormous cruise ship about to leave nearby Southampton docks.
Here's a cruise ship coming past. Cowes at the moment, over here. We're in the centre. Here's the Isle of Wight. Ride pier just about showing up.
Nearly as long as 3 football pitches and weighing more than 18 Eiffel Towers, the cruise ship can block the path of the hovercraft like a wall of steel.
If we're delayed getting away, we could find ourselves having to do quite a large detour around the stern of the cruise ship.
Jock closes the watertight hatches. To beat the most formidable obstacle of the weekend, he needs a quick start. The fastest route is for Jock to cut in front of the cruise ship, but time is running short for such a risky maneuver.
Touch and go. It's going to touch and go.
South Sea, you have clearance to depart.
Clear the park. Thanks, Mike.
As he sets off, Jock realizes he's left it too late to cut across the huge vessel's bow. Risking a collision with a ship this big is not an option. But the sun is setting, the queues on the other side are building, and the regatta's closing fireworks are less than an hour away. Jock has to stay on schedule.
We don't want to cut across our bows for less than a mile, so I've altered round and we're going to run round the stern of her.
Going round the back of the liner will cost time, but Jock makes the most of the detour.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Captain speaking. For those ship spotters on board, going down the port side now is cruise ship Britannia. on our way out to Stavanger.
Even such a tiny delay is a problem on a 10-minute crossing. Jock will need to push every advantage of the 12,000 TD to land on time. Both 12-cylinder engines are running at maximum revs to keep the hovercraft on schedule. To stop them from meltdown, high-capacity pumps pull 15 litres of cooling fluid from the engines every second and push them into copper radiators that provide a huge surface area to disperse the heat from the engines. And four massive fans then blast it out of the machine. It's a super-sized cooling system that stops the engines from blowing under the constant strain. The hovercraft's awesome twin engines provide Jock with the power to get out of the stickiest situations. And he can even take a moment to enjoy the view.
I think we're very privileged being out on the water at the moment. There's some quite remarkable ships, and they go past my office window on a daily basis. Brilliant.
Jock lands back on the island, on time. It's the end of a busy shift for the hovercraft team. The skilled ground crew, the pilots, and the extraordinary engineering of this remarkable machine have successfully carried almost 5,000 people, most of them on time.
96% over a month that we've left on time, both sides.
It's rather special. I think we're very privileged to be able to operate this unique water vehicle.
Team and machine have made it through the busiest weekend on one of the most crowded and challenging waterways in the world.
Each day is a different day, different challenges. Yeah, the hovercraft's great.
It's not the sort of job I think you'd ever get bored with it.